Australia's Olympic swimmers say they're raring to go as they count down to their campaign in Paris. As Hugh Whitfield reports, the Dolphins are in training camp near the French capital.
Our swimmers are basing themselves about an hour outside the French capital in the Gothic cathedral town of Chartres, where they've taken over a local aquatic centre and doing just a handful of things. Training, sleeping, eating and relaxing, trying to create that chilled atmosphere around our 44 swimmers, half of whom are debutantes, to try and block out all the noise that comes with the build-up to an Olympic Games, particularly that rivalry with Team USA. Cameron McAvoy, now a team veteran, back for his fourth Olympic Games. He is chasing an elusive gold in the 53.
I guess the last 13 years I've been on the team, I haven't seen a better bunch of swimmers who are both, I guess, mentally fortified for this approach, but also, I guess, physically prepared.
Meantime, one of the Kookaburras, our men's hockey team, has gone to extreme lengths to make sure he can compete here at the Olympic Games. Right now he's in the air between Perth and Paris, but just this week he was given an ultimatum by his doctors after breaking his ring finger. They told him he either had to miss the Games to recover or amputate the top of his finger, and he's gone for the amputation.
Obviously made an informed decision with the plastic surgeon at the time, and not only for the opportunity to play in Paris but for life after this as well. The best option was for me to take the top of my finger off.
So a slightly reduced Matt Dawson when he lands here in Paris, but it could be just the trick that the Kookaburras need to win gold here in Paris.